Dear students, this is Dr. Jagipriya from Annivela Valley College. Today we are going to learn about distributed computing system models. What is distributed computing system? Actually, distributed computing is a model in which components of the software systems are shared among multiple computers. Even though the components are spread out across multiple computers, they are run as one system. Okay. These models can be classified into five categories. First one, mini computer model. Second one, workstation model. Third one, workstation server model. Fourth, processor pool model. And the last one, hybrid model. Okay, the first model, mini computer model. Actually, it's a simple extension of centralized time sharing system. See in this diagram, a distributed computing system consists of few mini computers that are interconnected by a communication network. Here, each mini computer has multiple users simultaneously logged on to it. For this, several interactive terminals are connected to each mini computer, and each user is logged on to one specific mini computer with remote access to other mini computers. The network allows a user to access remote resources that are available on some other machine other than the one onto which the user is currently logged. The mini computer model may be used when resource sharing with remote users is desired. ARPA net is an example of a distributed computing system based on the mini computer model. Okay. Then the second one, workstation model. In this diagram, see, a distributed computing system based on this workstation model, it has several workstations interconnected by a communication network. Okay, a company's office or a department or a university may have several workstations. Each workstation equipped with its own disk and serving as a single user computer. See, in this model, a user logs on to one of the workstation called his or her home workstation and submit job for execution. When the system find that the user's workstation does not have sufficient processing power for executing the process, then it will transfer one or more of the process from the user's workstation to some other workstation that is currently idle and get the process executed there. And finally, the result of execution is returned to user's workstation. Okay. But this is not so simple to implement. It has lot of issues. Okay. The sprite system and experimental system, that are the examples of this model. Okay, distributed computing system based on the workstation model. Then third one, workstation server model. It's a network of personal workstations, each with its own disk and local file system. Okay, here the workstation with its local disk is usually called disk full workstation, and workstation without local disk is known as diskless workstation. Okay, in this diagram, a distributed computing system based on the workstation consists of few mini computers and several workstations, but all the systems are interconnected by a communication network. Okay, see, one mini computer is act as a file server, another one is act as a database server, and another one is act as a print server, and so on. Okay, this system has some of the advantages. The one of the advantages, it's very flexible compared with the previous one. Okay, then fourth one, processor pool model. It's based on the observation that most of the time a user does not need any computing power, but once in a while they need a very large amount of computing power for a short time. Okay, therefore, unlike workstation server model, here a processor is allocated to each user. In a processor pool model, the processors are pooled together to be shared by the users as needed. See, in this figure, in the pure processor pool model, the processors in the pool have no terminals attached directly to them, and the users access the system from terminals that are attached to the network through special devices. Okay, then next, last one, hybrid model. Based on the workstation server model, but with the addition of pool of processors. Actually, hybrid model is the combination of workstation server model and processor pool model. Okay, to combine the advantages of both the workstation server and processor pool model, a hybrid model may be used to build a distributed computing system. Using this model, user can execute simple interactive tasks such as editing job, sending email, and executing small programs and all. And also, user can execute some massive calculations because processor pool model also combined, na, that's what. Okay, it's more attractive and suitable, but it's very expensive. Thank you.